let me thank all of you for participating in the Why NPTEL contest. This contest, the background of this contest was, it's been 5 years since we started the idea of NPTEL local chapters. And it was in May 2015 that the first local chapter, first few local chapters were officially onboarded to NPTEL. And we have seen tremendous growth in terms of how this format of local chapter-based participation is happening. And over the years, we have been compared with, NPTEL is a Government of India project aimed at reaching out to the last mile learner in India. So this is one project which was aimed at with this initiative. And it was in 2014 that we adopted the massive open online course format that was becoming pretty popular at that point of time. And what we have tried to do was, we have tried to identify what will be like a good MOOC format for Indian learners. And since then, we have been compared with a lot of, international MOOC providers, Coursera, edX, Udacity, even the popular marketplace MOOC of Udemy, which runs in a completely different model altogether. So each of these programs or platforms have their own fundamental ideology that actually runs how the courses are brought in and how it is being offered to students. And NPTEL more or less is a MOOC platform, but the one big differentiator, if you look at it, is we have tried to customize it to the Indian academic institutions and also generally to Indian learners so that they will get the benefit not just of learning, but also of certification. So we have been learning from what each of you have been experiencing and also learning from other platforms as well. So we thought it might be a good idea to listen from our own learners who have been taking courses from other platforms and what they see as possibilities of improvements for NPTEL in these while comparing with these international platforms. So initially we thought of just taking the four platforms, well-known platforms of Coursera, Udacity, edX and FutureLearn. But we have seen that there are also other MOOC platforms which are more than a lakh, have a learner base of more than a lakh. And we have considered some of those as well when you have provided your presentations. So in today's session, we have these many participants. If you actually look at, you can see that a lot of you have taken courses from Coursera, a few from edX. There is representation from Udemy and MongoDB courses as well. MongoDB is the MongoDB University. But in general, and if you look at the, and this is a competition that was specifically run for local chapters across the country. So we have a good representation from both faculty and student from these local chapters. We had asked the single point of contacts or SPOCs of each local chapter to do an internal screening and then select the best participants from their own local chapters, which can which will lead to a much more intense discussion and much more clarity and articulation of points. So these kind of ideas can be discussed across multiple fora, one of which is this webinar. If you see, so this is a webinar of, so we will be having two such webinars. The first webinar we have around around 18 participants are expected in this webinar, and we have few of the SPOCs also joining in for this. So thank you everyone. So if you see your name, yes, so thank you for all. And I can see that we have a total of 25 participants in this webinar. So without much delay, let me go to the key questions that we wanted to discuss with each of you. So I have prepared a outline level of three major focus questions that have come out from all your presentations. I mean, this was one point that each one of you had mentioned in your Y NPTEL presentation. So these are those points. Okay. So basically, the video length or the video presentation technique, and a little bit about the peer interactions and discussion forums across platforms. And also, most of you have talked a lot about the certification value among Indian institutions as well as employers that you see as a prime differentiator between multiple platforms. So I would like to open up the discussion for each one of you. We will take it question, sub-question by sub-question, okay? So which means we will start off with what we call as the first one. How do you currently learn from NPTEL videos? This is something that we would want to know.
First of all, I would like to say that what ma'am said was correct, like length of the video should be reduced to somewhat extent, because I am myself a NPTEL learner, and what I do is sometimes when I have less time, I just put it on the 2x mode and then quickly complete my video. So the video should be shortened a bit. And the second thing I want to say in the NPTEL's good point, like the accent of the teachers here in NPTEL as compared to those MOOC websites like Coursera, the accent of teachers here is more of Indian like accent, so it is a bit easy to understand from as compared to them, because they have something American accent which Indians have find some difficulty to understand. And and third thing which I want to say is that while presenting the videos, the teachers should somewhat be like should involve with students somewhat, like they can cover the whole podium and make some gestures so that student can develop constant interest in what they are speaking. Like I have found in some other MOOC websites like Coursera, the teachers there are like the camera is at a distance from the podium, and the teachers walk through the whole stage and they constantly interact and make some gestures, and it is a bit interesting while learning. It does not bore the student. And the next thing is that, like, when we are watching videos, the teachers teach us with the help of the PowerPoint presentations, and after that we get the transcripts and the PPT presentations. But I think this alone is not enough. They should also give some and notes also, so that student can develop a better understanding and a comprehensive understanding about the subject, and it would be benefit also for the students.
So does Coursera courses give you notes or other kind of things? Like, I mean, is that how Coursera courses run?
Not all the courses, but it will be a definitely good point if NPTEL follows this in order to leave Coursera behind, because some courses are there in them, like they provide extra notes, probably they give another link for the notes, but it can be a good point of NPTEL over the Coursera if this thing is followed.
Okay, so one question that I have for, I mean, whenever learners tell this is, I mean, you are in higher ed, so isn't it, I mean, implicitly assume that you will be taking your own notes rather than listening, I mean, just waiting for the instructor's notes on it, because instructor's notes is what is there in the slide. That is what he summarizes. So what is the difference between, what is the difference that a student considers between an instructor's lecture and instructor's note?
Okay, so meaning like if we see instructor notes, when they provide the presentation, instructor sometimes what he does is like he takes an empty PowerPoint slide and he tries to explain some derivations over that slide. But when we get that PowerPoint for our downloading, it is not available on that slide. Okay. Are you able to understand what I'm saying?
Yeah. So more or less what you see that derivation explanation is coming in the transcript also, right? So the transcript plus PowerPoint presentation is actually a good note in itself, right?
It can be a good note, but to have a systematic approach means, and students sometimes have to wander across different websites. Maybe they can, maybe NEPTEL can provide some links to some good websites which have some good notes over it. But it can, it will be a more systematic approach if we give some notes also, meaning like, for example, there are some courses in which there are some source codes some applications of some libraries and et cetera and et cetera. Mm-hmm. So what I've seen in other websites, like they give first of all a short note. In the transcript we have some extraneous things also, some noisy things also. But in notes we have to the point concise notes of that particular topics, and we can go through them quickly and just revise them quickly. Whereas in transcripts and presentation is too much short, and transcripts are too much lengthy. So I think the notes is the exact concise way of representing.
Sir, first of all, I would like to tell you that, sir, I always make my own notes when I see the video, because it helps me at the last moment to revise, because it is not possible before the certification exam to go through the all the video lectures again. So what I do, when I see the video, I prepare my short notes with them. So throughout the video, I make notes, and at the last I just revise them. So this makes me score good in an NPTEL exam. So I think it is my strategy to answer. I don't think that a student need notes, because sir, actually handwritten notes or our own notes is very much I think is much sufficient than NPTEL's notes, because when we sir the problem is that when NPTEL this provides this PDF, so what happens, sir, many of the students they do not prepare their own notes, and they just go through the PDF. But what happens, sir, in this process, the very essence of learning dies. Sir, I do not see any difference in the video length, because I am a student, so I can devote much time. But there are many learners who are professionals, so I don't think they have this much time to watch this longer video. So we can also make short videos like of 20 minutes, 30 minutes, because sir, in edX or in Coursera, they make very short videos, like 5-minute videos, 10-minute videos. So I think NPTEL can also do this thing, but do not make 5 or 10 minute video, because there is not much content in 5 or 10 minute video. But we can also around 20 to 25, 30 minutes is enough, I think. Sir, in few courses of the NPTEL, we have to little will work on the teaching methodology. My friends also raised this question of the, sir, one way transmission of knowledge that a teacher is sitting and just delivering the lecture. So, sir, it is not the thing the teacher is sitting or is moving, but as per say that, sir, the teacher can also share their own experiences. I'm talking about the not of the that normative teaching, but kind of empirical teaching, like many of the teachers, what they do, they just read out from the PDFs. So I think, sir, it not work in the century. So I think they can share their own experiences. So,
sir, I like to add some more points with Shikha, what she said. She said about the monotonous length of the video, everything. I would like to add one more thing along with this, that is interactive quizzes in between the video. During the video itself, I'm talking about Coursera. That is the course I done in the MOOC. So I'm telling, like, during the ongoing course, in between, you can have some quizzes in between, so that it will be interesting for the students.
So they will are you talking of in-video quizzes or quizzes just immediately following the video?
In-video.
Okay, in-video quizzes.
Ongoing video, yes, in between quizzes can be added. Pop-up window will come and you can answer. If you don't know, you can skip the video. I mean, skip the quiz and you can go ahead. You can continue the video. You can complete the video. That's the process.
So what happens when these quizzes are shown? So let's say you skip out the quiz. What is the benefit of then adding the quiz in between the video?
Main thing is, I'm talking about Coursera. Duration of Coursera, all the videos are very less. hardly some 10 minutes, 15 minutes, that's all. And we will have like, we are sitting along with them. Teachers are not autonomous and we have some kind of attachment with them because we feel like we are speaking with them. So that is already there, and they are raising the question in between. For a second, it is flashing and it is going. So you feel like what is there, that excitement that will be created there.
Okay. And so, you as a learner will feel like, okay, what was asked? Let me look at it. That kind of feeling comes.
Yes, and, definitely. So and, that excitement will be created, and that will create more interest for the students. That is what I felt.
Yeah. So what do you do when these kind of questions are asked? Do you go back to the video and check what the answer is to answer it, or do you just wait for the correct answer to be shown in the video itself?
According to Coursera, if you don't know the answer, you can go back and you can see, or you can skip the quiz and you can go ahead with the video.
Okay. And so does it contribute to learning? So I understand the wow factor.
Yes, of course. Like a teacher asking question in between and you don't know to answer, what you will react? The same way. But this is not a real world, virtual world. So we have a lot of time. We can go back, we can see, and we can come back and answer. If you don't know, we can skip and go. Okay. Like in school classes, how teachers ask question and how students will ask answer. The same way, same pattern.
Okay.
But in the form of quiz.
Yeah, got it. And do you want these quizzes to be graded or ungraded?
Ungraded.
Okay.
It creates interest, that's all.
Okay, great. Yeah.
If it is graded, that's fine only, because then students will have more. They have all the students, they have to go through the video compulsory. Otherwise, we can go through the transcript and we can write the answer and we can get the certificate.
Okay. And is there something else? So any additional points that you want to add to what all your other colleagues have already said?
One more thing I want to add, sir. That is programming. I never seen any programming kind of thing in NPTEL, and somebody before me also mentioned like all the equations will be derived and finally we get in the transcript. That one thing, that is about derivation. The like ways for programming, this Coursera, how they are offering is they themselves giving the software like split screen, in the sense they are showing in one half of the page they are doing and one half they are allowing us to do. So it will be like we can do along with them, like a master sitting along with us and doing. Split screen option is there, so we can complete the courses, we can learn new programming languages and all. I felt it is very good.
Which programming language was taught like this?
This Python, this Jupyter, like this and all, they given, sir. Sentimental analysis and yes sir, tell me.
So they actually gave a interface within the video, or how was this happening?
Not within the video, sir. Entire screen is divided into two halves. One side master will be doing.
Okay.
Not exactly the real master, virtually everything master will be doing, and this half of the page they given to us, the same software they are using, the same half they given, same page divided into two. So in one of the half they will be doing, along with them we also can do the same program, we can run, we can execute, and we can see what is output.
Okay. So rather than a video of the execution, you are you are actually working along with the teacher.
Yes, sir. That's what.
Actually, I completed a MongoDB course from MongoDB University, sir, where that experience was very nice, sir, because they provided a sandbox where we execute our coding. We gave rights to access their database and thereby executed our query, and thereby we submitted the assignment, sir. That is very nice. Usually in assignment, one question will be there, and for that query, from that options, we have to click our answer, right, sir? So not like that. In that MongoDB course, they provided a sandbox, and we have rights to access their database and the executed query, and thereby provided our assignment, sir. That is a very nice one, sir, compared to that.
In NPTEL, they provide a good variety of contents. In content wise, it is very elaborately dealed compared to the Coursera. And In NPTEL, we have also the option of downloading the transcripts and studying in offline mode also. It is very useful for the students from rural areas compared with Coursera.
So Coursera does not have
in Coursera,
so Coursera does not have a transcript download.
They have a transcript download, but not like NPTEL, sir. Like detailed explanation is not present over there compared to Coursera. Comparing with Coursera, sorry.
Okay. And hello? Yeah. Go ahead.
And downloadable videos also is preferable in NPTEL, whereas Coursera lacks that. We cannot download the video offline mode and you can access it.
Okay, got it. So it is that, so what you're talking of is in the NPTEL.ac.in site, right? That's where you download all these videos and transcripts. Whereas Coursera does not have a mechanism like that. But Coursera videos, aren't they downloadable from while you are online?
We can use in cloud platform, but it is not like you can access those contents after like what I'm saying like is you can download it through Coursera, but it is only through cloud online.
Okay.
Can you get me?
Yeah. But okay. My question is generally NPTEL.ac.in is also online. So what are you talking of when you say that it is available offline? Is there other ways through which you get the NPTEL videos?
Like we can download it and you can learn later. That's what I'm saying.
Okay.
Whenever we want, students can access it.
Okay, but isn't downloading from cloud also the same functionality? As in, you download and keep it and you access it at a later point of time. So what is the significant difference between NPTEL's download and Coursera's download?
Coursera, it doesn't have every detailed content. But in NPTEL, module-wise, there is a lot of steps present. I feel like that.
So my question was... I have done a lot of courses from EDX and Coursera. The main thing which I wanted to discuss was some courses are self-paced in edX and Coursera. They provide some self-paced course so that if a student is willing to get a certificate at any time, they can. They don't have to wait for the semester, or they don't have to wait for the enrollment. They can just enroll the course. They can register themselves. They can pay the fees, and they can pursue the course at their own speed. And the second thing which I wanted to ask was for some older courses, like I did a course in compiler design in NPTEL in computer science. For the new courses, the video lectures are available in full HD 1080p. But for some older courses like compiler design and all, which were pre-recorded and when online teaching was started, so the quality of the video is not that good as compared to the new videos which are coming.
Okay. So there are certain courses. So I'll answer this question towards the end of it regarding the self-paced courses. But I do take up, do understand your the second grievance that compared to the newer videos, even within NPTEL platforms, certain courses have older videos. So it may be good idea to reshoot that entire content in HD and present it. Right. That's what you are mentioning,
yes,
right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, and in general, what is your strategy of learning from videos in general, be it any platform? What kind of strategies do you adopt?
So like when I was doing my grade preparation, so the very main thing of learning from the videos is that you can take notes, you can pause the videos, and you can learn at your own speed. Like if I'm not able to understand some concept, I can rewatch the videos. I can even change the speed of watching the videos to 2x and 3x depending on my learning speed. I can make some notes according to the videos. You know, I can download the transcripts to get the better picture of what the professor is saying and all.
Okay. So by this, what do you say? By this particular angle, then it means for you, the video length does not matter that much, right? I mean, if
no,
you
sir.
are, So, I mean, in general, there is a conception that the length of videos are pretty long in NPTEL. So, how, I mean, since you have been doing GATE preparations, okay, one comment that we typically hear from GATE N2 candidates is that NPTEL having such a long videos helps us in understanding the concept more. Whereas the other one with shorter videos, you're not able to understand the concept very clearly. So do you echo some kind of feeling similar to this?
Okay, sir. So I'll try to answer this question with an example. So I did the two courses. The first one was database management system. It was from IIT Kharagpur. And the second one was discrete mathematics. It was from IIT Roper. I believe both are lengthy courses, but the discrete mathematics needs more focus of your brain to get that understanding. But I would agree. I will agree with this point that some videos are lengthy, and like in DBMS, they were explaining some concepts which were not required for GATE. Means that was for general knowledge, and the videos were very lengthy. But in discrete mathematics, they explained it very lucidly and very concisely. So only relevant things were given to us in a very short short span of video. So I found that thing very fascinating. And in fact, that was new video which was being recorded here. I think this thing lacks in older videos which was recorded previously.
Okay. And so when you compare it with, so do you use Coursera or edX videos for your competitive examination preparation?
So strictly, I don't use Coursera or edX for my competitive examination. I only use NPTEL. But for learning some different things and learning some new courses, I go for Coursera and edX.
So, what are the new things? So, I mean, can you give an example of what these new things are?
Yes, sir. So, recently, I did a course called Omen Prophecies and Omens and Prophecies. It was from HarvardX. So I believe the catalog in NPTEL is shorter than that of EDX and all. So like if some student want to go for soft skill courses or management courses or some other courses, he cannot find each and every course in NPTEL. So EDX has more catalog of courses. So no students switch for that, for if they want to upgrade themselves for some new courses which is not present in NPTEL.
What I would be telling when I compare with this note-taking habit of any student, like I could compare it with Coursera and other things. What they have now, they have online screen sharing for notes. So you can just copy the text, whichever you feel is important or very much necessary. Like you can take it up and copy and paste. That option could be added up in NPTEL, sir. That is okay. One suggestion. Because notes taking is available in parallel with the course itself, along with the transcript, it is available in courses available at Coursera and all those stuff. And length, certainly the length of the video does matter because NPTEL, not only faculty, students also have the habit, even starting from first year, they do take up the course. When it happens to be so long, it has a monotonous feel. If it is being reduced to short durations, it would be better. And as Prasad sir said, these things, like you can give annotations kind of things, questions, quiz kind of thing, whatever you had completed for the short duration. And you can just refresh on that or brush up on that, asking some small questions, and you can move on with it. And one more point which I would like to tell is that practical exposure kind of thing, like lab kind of courses, when you have something like Internet of Things course in the in the curriculum, like you can add up some practical assignments with the assignment questions other than problematic and theoretical. You can just ask them to install some app and note down their what is their signal strength for the wireless services which they have, and they can post up their answers. That kind of thing, if it is being incorporated, it will be better. That is my suggestion, sir. When I have taken courses both in NPTEL as well as Coursera, on comparing these two things, I feel these changes will give a better color to NPTEL, sir.
The points are well taken. So yes, the annotation, screen grab of the annotations from the video to online notes, etc. That is a technological thing that we will be looking into. But again, as you know, we are trying to give the accessibility to even the remote areas. So we want to ensure that accessibility exists before moving on into a larger technical changes at our end. So hopefully, yes, we are looking at a couple of features that we would want in our system. Thank you for your inputs. Now I will move ahead to Ritik. Ritik, you have raised your hand again. Are you available now?
So my experience was that rather being learning lonely, my friends and I were learning in a group so that we can get the things very precisely. Or we could, at the time, if we are not gaining that concept, we would discuss at the time, at the instance of time, and we were possible to get that thing very quickly. Also, as Mohini sir said, that we should prepare notes and we should be there. His idea was that's called in-video quiz. So at a particular time, there is a quiz at particular time. So we can get the questions correctly and we could get those things very quickly. So that's a very good idea. That's called in-video quiz. And taking down the notes, is a very good thing because we have a writing practice and that thing will stuck in mind.
Okay. So Ritik, when you compare the standard, so you said you collaborate with your friends or colleagues while yes. learning. Is there some strategy like, okay, you watch one video, I watch this video, together we'll share, or is it that both of you watch the same video at the same time?
No. We both watch the same video at the same time.
And is it that you pause at points where you feel that there is difficulty, or how do you manage that? I mean, how is that particular learning happening?
As we encounter a problem or we don't get the concept, we just pause the video. Me and my colleague just discuss that thing and get the things clear out.
Okay. And during this collaborative session, do you take notes? Both of you take notes, or is it just discussion?
No, yes, sir. We take notes, handwritten notes, as it's a good practice, you know. Huh. So, it's a good practice that we used to take down the notes and just look over it, and it gets stuck in the mind.
In general, in massive open online courses. So, if you look at a regular face-to-face learning, you learn a lot from your peers. Okay. It may be your friends, it may be through combined study, or it may be through various other mechanisms that are available. But a general observation by different participants about discussion forums is we need to have more active or enthusiastic discussion forum in NPTEL courses compared to, let's say, a edX course or a Coursera course. So here are certain questions that we wanted answer to. So this is more about peer interactions and discussion forums. We wanted to understand typically how peer interactions happen in other courses. And what do you see in NPTEL courses compared to the other courses? And what are the things that we can learn from other platforms so that our peer interactions improve significantly? And also about this idea of peer evaluations or peer grading. This came in around 7 to 8 of the short presentations that you made. Some of you have mentioned, so around 7 of 8 of you have mentioned about peer evaluation or peer grading. So we had Shinbagavadi who talk, I mean, I think one participant talk about the peer evaluation happening. So I think Sri Patmini. So we just want to understand the idea that you have about peer interactions, either in discussion forum or in general through the assessment questions. So we have the hand raises. So I'll give preference to people who have not spoken till now first. So we have Parkavi A raising the hand for the second question. So Parkavi, can you hear us?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So Parkavi, yeah, why don't you go ahead and talk about the discussion forum and the peer interaction that you have in both NPTEL and the other platforms.
Yes, sir. In Coursera, I have taken course before taking up in the NPTEL. Long back, I have taken because after that they started offering for like we have to pay the money for taking the course. So after that, I didn't take in the Coursera. So that time, discussion forum was very active and peer evaluation also. Like we have to evaluate another 5 peers. We have to evaluate, and similarly, they have to evaluate ours and self-evaluation also available there in Coursera, but that's lacking in the NPTEL. I felt because for everything we have some intellect, sir. So whatever the peer evaluation I have taken and whatever the scores I got for my assignments, like I felt they are correct. They give good suggestion because I have taken for teaching learning process related courses. So the comments what they have passed over my assignments, really they are worth enough. So I have considered, like, sometimes very bad comments also they give, like this is like not making sense, that kind of comment also I have received. So it will help us in growing up our knowledge and attitude. We have to take up whatever the good and bad comments the peers they give. I have got both, some of them appreciated, some of them like they have given whatever they felt. So it will help us, sir. I feel peer evaluation should be there. We always should not say that like people will not give good marks. Even in the laboratories also, in like offline courses, what we conduct in labs or in the classes, peer evaluation, we can introduce. Like that's the way how we have to cultivate the intellect among the students community. Okay. I feel that should be there.
Okay. And what about discussion forum? So, I mean, the discussion forum is open even in...
Yes, sir. Yes. They are equivalently, they are good. And now recently we have taken on digital transformation one course. I have taken Swayam NPTEL, that is like under TechCube. In that, like how much we are involved in discussion forum, that also they have considered for evaluation. So okay. In that, that they can introduce for other courses also, like where students also involved in that. No, because under TechCube, when they have provided for Swayam NPTEL courses, for digital transformation, that time they told that, okay, digital, how good you are involved in digital discussion forum, that also we'll consider. So initially we felt like forcibly we found out, okay, which area we are really interested in, like that we started getting involved, but it was interesting.
Okay. Like, and I mean, for that matter, all the NPTEL, I mean, it is the same, exactly the same Swayam NPTEL platform that you see even for that course also, right? So this is a TechCube course that you have undertaken, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
That's only for teachers. That's only for teachers. So they have considered a discussion forum also, like we so have to involve in it.
Is it that teachers discuss more than students, or is it something like that?
It's like reasonably they have responded, sir, because we get updates in our mails, no? Like they are... I didn't expect that much they'll take it serious and discuss, but they have really, they have, some of them have agreed the point what we have told about peer evaluation, collaborative teamwork, all those things. So it's good, sir. So it has to come, discussion forum also has to be evaluated. Like people should get involved in discussing with others.
And what that is will the benefit? Help them. Yeah, what is the benefit, key benefit that you saw in those discussion forums?
We will get motivated to acquire, okay, even if somebody says good point, like, okay, your point is correct also, we will accept it. If somebody says, okay, this is not a good point, why it is, that reason also will come to know, sir. Will be the open-mindedness will improve in us. So if it is open for the students also, like whatever the courses available for our engineering students, really they'll, nowadays, no, like if you say you have to do this means like, no, we'll not do, like that kind of mentality it is raising. That's why people go in wrong way. And also we have to cultivate that.
Okay. And so this is what you said is actually a Swayam non-NPTEL course, right? What you said, the digital transformation course.
Yes.
What about courses in, so you said you took a Coursera course in 2015. So was it also such an active discussion forum that was happening?
Yes, sir. Yeah. Whenever we have doubt, we used to discuss there. But so, presently, how is it? I don't know. But that time in discussion forum, sometimes we get doubt. We used to discuss there after the quiz and all. We used to discuss there.
So what is different in NPTEL courses? So NPTEL courses also open up the discussion forum.
It's like both are similar, sir. Both are similar. I didn't find anything different there apart from the TechCube course what I have taken. I didn't find any difference.
So this TechCube course was taken by, I believe, Dr. Samir, right?
Sir. I don't remember the name exactly.
Okay, no problem. So what all things happened in that TechCube course? Was it, how did they sustain so much? I mean, so around how many participants would have been there? Around 2,000, 3,000 participants?
Many, sir. Yeah, in thousands.
So how did they manage such a discussion? How did that happen?
They asked us to open a thread and you post a query, they told, and I used to post the query, and whenever people respond to that, I used to get the updates in my mail. So it's very good. Like, so even if you forget to watch in the discussion forum, it pop up in your inbox, in your mail. So we'll come to know, this is a different way. Like this also people will think like that where I started.
Okay, so was it an instruction which was given in through videos or was it?
Yes, sir, they have given. We have to involve in discussion forums like that. They have given.
Okay, and so what all things are there? I mean, so just involved in discussion or was it more elaborated? How did they ask you to discuss?
That's the instruction given, sir. When you involve for the course, so many instructions they'll give, no, sir? Like that, in that instruction sheet, I have seen, they have given like that.
Okay. Yeah, thanks, Bhargavi, for that.
Sir, I'm Elvin Jeeva from New Prince Sri Bhavani College of Engineering and Technology. Sir, I have done some courses in NPTEL as well as Coursera also. But always I feel NPTEL has the best active forum, sir, because since I am in mathematics department, I always find maximum I found some mistakes in NPTEL assignment question because of lot of symbols are there in mathematics. So I always find some mistakes are there. So whenever I write questions in forums, they immediately within 1 or 2 days, it's a maximum within a day itself, they send a mail and rectify the mistakes. But in Coursera, it will take nearly a month. So in Coursera, I have taken one courses like analytics. So in the last assignment, there is one mistake in the mistakes in the assignment question. So a lot of other teams also write the question like there is a mistake. So even 8 months, even there is 8 months ago, but no one answer, no instructors are answer the particular questions also. So I always feel NPTEL has the best active forums compared to Coursera.
Okay.
So in the Coursera, their students only answer the questions. So okay, they only discuss it. But in NPTEL, even instructors immediately respond to our questions. Whenever they say see, they immediately respond to our question.
Okay.
So I feel NPTEL has the best active forums.
Okay. And so have you taken up, let's say, something like a peer evaluation?
Yes, sir. Question? I always feel ingenuity in the peer evaluation because there in Coursera, I have taken a course like statistics or probability. So in that peer evaluation, I found 5 questions. So totally 3 questions only I answered correctly. But finally, I got 100 out of 100 marks. So that is, I always feel that is the ingenuity in that. So after that, I won't attend that peer graded courses.
Okay.
Yes, the ingenuity, I always feel. There is no ethical also.
Okay,
so only 3 questions, only corrected. So, but I got 100 out of 100. I don't know how. But so ingenuity in that. So after that, I never attend that peer graded assignment and all. Peer graded course even I also won't take after that.
Okay. So it's yes, yeah.
So it's,
yeah.
Even some students or other peers, other students or other faculty or other peers only evaluate our papers, is it? Mm. So they just close their eyes or just put full marks and all. So yeah. I always it's not worth it.
So I got some new points here. I want to add one point is our mentors are there. Okay. In NPTEL local chapter, we are having some mentors. If we give mentors chance to discuss in the discuss form, it will be helpful for the students as well as the candidates who have applied for that. So mentors can play a major role here. And moreover, students who are asking the questions are participating in the discussion form. Okay. We can give some bonus points.
Okay.
Okay. This bonus points, what it will do is, it will encourage the students to participate more in this.
Okay. So have you seen such a strategy adopted in Coursera courses? Because Parkavi madam was talking of how a particular course, a non-NPTEL SWAYAM course, use discussion forums effectively. So like that, have you seen any other courses where the discussion forum participation was used for grading or other kind of activities?
Actually, in Coursera, I have come across the discussion forum. But as LDA ma'am has told, LDN ma'am has told, no, sir, because when the question is given, it is taking some long time. It's taking the long period of time to answer that particular query.
Okay.
But in our NPTEL, we are having the other social media like Facebook also we are having, right, sir?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. In the same manner, if we have the study groups also, it will be helpful in this discussion forum, sir.
Absolutely. Good. Yeah, thanks. Yeah.
Study groups. Mentors and also bonus points I want to add, sir.
Question 2A, sir, active discussion forum, sir. The student engagement is a big issue in all these platforms. I found that it is an issue in Coursera, edX, as well as in NPTEL. Sir, what we can do with NPTEL courses, like how to engage student engagement. So, sir, we can use this model of discussion forum moderator, which we have used in our the offering of the designing learner-centric MOOC. Sir, this previous section session. So, sir, we have worked together for this discussion forum moderator model. So, I think you know much about it.
So, yeah, sir, yeah. So, in this we can I know it. So, see the okay. So, in general, to all participants, the others do not know this course, and it is not right that I speak about it. So, why don't you tell your experience in the in the course that you had taken a couple of semesters back and what happened afterwards? So can you elaborate a little bit about, because it is also a model that we are trying out in NPTEL. So why don't you talk about it rather than me talking about it?
Yes, sir. To everyone, discussion forum moderators model, it is a model in which what happens that the topper of the previous session, they are offered a kind of position like the discussion forum moderator. They have to moderate the discussion. And they have to answer the queries of the student or the learners who are enrolled in the present semester. So basically, those who are the discussion forum moderators, they are the learners of the previous offering who has stopped the exam. So they have engaged like this way. So in this way, the student engagement is fostered. So I think, sir, we can extend this model to each and every course offered by NPTEL. So in this way, we can solve this problem of student engagement. The another issue, sir, peer evaluation. So, sir, I do not found peer evaluation good for the learners, because, sir, they are not actually like correct. Because, sir, I have also done a course on Coursera, and they use this peer evaluation method. So, sir, this is helpful for the teacher to reduce his or her efforts, but I think it did good for me.
Sir, I also feel like peer graded assignments are not fair. Like, if we want, even if some people, if they don't have the knowledge about the subject also, they put high marks, low marks. Like that, it happens. For me also, it happened. In Coursera.
Okay, this is in Coursera courses. And yeah, go ahead.
In Coursera, yes. And I also feel like in peer graded assignments, one more thing is the submission process. If two or more peers submit, only we can, then only we can also submit. And the correction procedure is also very delayed. Like it takes time so that the course completion time also it delays for us.
Okay.
Like getting certifications.
Okay. And you were talking of discussion forums also earlier, right? You had some point regarding peer interactions.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so what was that point that you wanted to highlight at that point of time regarding discussion?
Like, NPTEL has a better NPTEL has a better discussion forum compared with Coursera. Because they reach out, in NPTEL, they reach out within 1 or 2 days. Whereas Coursera, it lags that. Only students also post in discussion forums, but mentors, lagging in discussing.
Okay.
So I feel NPTEL is better compared with Coursera discussion forum.
NPTEL discussion forum more active as compared to other MOOCs courses worldwide. I put my questions and at discussion forum and I received rapid responses. Even NPTEL discussion forum motivated us to participate actively. So it is also a learning process. Some students, teachers asking what is the way of asking, then our learned professors are responding. And now I come on peer evaluation. So what I experienced when I marked low grade to others, so I received a suggestion that it is a learning process, you should not do so. So I have decided I should give more marks. So I have started this thing. And I have also received more grades. So
this is in a Coursera course or which platform have you done?
Coursera. In okay. Coursera peer evaluation, I have experienced such type of things. When I marked a low grade, so I have received a message that you should do not you should not do so. You should peer properly. So then after that, I have decided I should give more marks as a peer.
Okay.
So then I also received more marks.
Yeah.
And
thank
submission
you,
and submission through mobile is not possible. It is not mobile friendly submission process. It requires a desktop.
Okay. Yeah, this is for the NPTEL courses, right?
No, Coursera, in Coursera, submission of review is difficult.
Okay.
Through mobile,
okay.
It requires desktop. So it delay our submission process.
Okay, sir. So thank you very much, Amit Bodh, sir. Let me now handpick learners, because there have been a lot of people who have been silently listening to most of the discussion. Now, before I move to that final phase, let me ask each one of you individually. So, Arundhati, Nirmal, she has raised her hand. Yeah, so Arundhati, yes, please, you can speak now.
Yes, sir. So I just wanted to add that, like many others said, that there is a small chance of ingenuity in the graded assignments. But even though we get to learn a lot from by reading, it is on Coursera, a course that I attended, it was compulsory that we had to grade at least 5 assignments. So
okay.
We tend to read a lot more, and our perspective on the topic gets more broader. So it was really helpful for me to also, we understand what other peers understand from the course. The perspective differs a lot. So,
Thanks, Arundhati. Is there anything else that you would want to, let's say, highlight were regarding this peer evaluation or discussions in general in NPTEL forum. Because see, from the webinar that we are seeing a positive belief that NPTEL forums are being well responded and NPTEL forums are more active. Whereas if you look at the submissions that have been come from different participants, there is a general observation that NPTEL forums are not as active as other course platforms discussion forums. So what is your observation on this? Is it varying or contrasting, or was it similar?
So in terms of discussion forums, I agree with others that NPTEL has a good platform, but written work assignments and you read a lot more in discussion forums. There are short discussions, not explanatory ones. No, so
okay,
reading one person's perspective in which is a lot more longer, you get to understand what they're trying to convey easily. These discussion forums, I feel, lack that because they are too short and you don't clearly understand what they're trying to say.
Good evening, everyone. I'm more of a silent listener, but I agree with all the points that I've stated before. The discussion forum of NPTEL is far better than Coursera. I've taken a course in Coursera where I learned Python, and I've done a course in NPTEL where I learned ethical hacking. During the course, there was a lot of problem with the, since it was a practical, it was more of a practical based course, there was a lot of problem with the the person who was handling the practical was, there was a lot of problem with the way he was speaking and the quality of the video. And the moment I reported, I mean, after 1 or 2 days, we got the reply that they're going to change, they're going to do better. And the professor himself added another video for that and the live sessions as well. So I think the discussion forums are really, really helpful. Whereas I posted a doubt in Coursera and around 1 month ago, and after that I got a reply. So I completely agree with all the previous speakers who have spoken before me.
Okay, yeah, thanks Aditi. And yeah, one important thing, even though you are a silent listener, do understand that we liked your presentation, so we would want you to contribute in the in future. If we run such webinars, active participation is something that we also expect in a webinar, because we have only such a small crowd. Okay.
Actually, I just want to add one thing with my experience. In this COVID-19, AKTU, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam Technical University, has asked you for students whose classes during this COVID-19. They asked to upload our video for Unit 3, 4, and 5. And when we start uploading the video, the student request is that please make it in Hindi, sir. So we start uploading the video in Hindi, and you don't believe that when I was uploading video in English, its reachability around 100-200. When I start video in Hindi, then it is reachability about 1,000 or more than 1,000 in a day. So it is very beneficial to students, as we know that in India, Hindi is our native language. So we think that our video is in Hindi language also. So NPTEL take initiative that it's transcript in Hindi, but I think it is more beneficial said that it is in Hindi language also. The speech should be in Hindi language. So if I compare with the Coursera, then it's okay. One main advantage with NPTEL is that the quizzes, the answers of quizzes are not available on internet. If NPTEL found these answers on internet, and then they easily track it and remove that answers. But in Coursera, you see that these answers are on GitHub and Quizlets from a very long past. I think it is from last 2 or 3 years ago. The same question and same answer. And one of my colleague has I think 27 Coursera courses in just 20 days. How is it possible? Is it possible that the answers, the quizzes are already available on Quizlet or in GitHub? But it is very tough to give answers on NPTEL. But there is one more thing, that whenever NPTEL share its assignments, there are some misconception that some answers were wrong, and later on NPTEL did what? He just correct the answer. So I just want to share that please don't stop it. Please stop it doing this, and please do correct the answer before presenting the student, and make the video in Hindi so that its reachability to students also, more students also.
Yeah, yeah. Thank you, sir. Yeah, Avdesh ji, the thing with languages is again, it's not just one belt that we are focusing on. We are focusing on students across multiple regions across the country. So doing in Hindi, yes, a major belt gets covered. In fact, we had one course which was delivered in Hindi this time, signals and system in Hindi from IIT Delhi. The feedback that we have seen is, I mean, the takers were there, but we haven't seen any major changes per se in the behavior of learners in the assignments or the other aspects of it. Maybe the viewership of the video would have increased, but we haven't seen a significant difference in the way learners took up this course and the way the learners answered assignments. So, which is slightly, I mean, we will try out these kind of experiments continuously. It's not that we are not immune to new ideas, or we will stop an idea if we don't see too much. So we will definitely experiment. But regarding assignments, yes, so there are mixed opinions. But again, see, at the end of the day, we are using the honor code. That means we believe that learners are not looking at each other's answers or not sharing answers with each other, not just through internet fora, but also through WhatsApp or other kind of mechanism. So we hope that, so that's what I wanted to understand in terms of discussion. So the focus question that I wanted to discuss. So I completely agree to the points and I accept it as constructive suggestions.
Here our discussion is confined to the discussion forum and the peer learning, peer reviewed assignments kinds of stuff. So here I would like to tell you one thing, sir. Our discussion forum remains very active, but that is unilateral active. Means the questions we used to put, participants used to post large in number, but hardly we used to get appropriate response, I would say. I mean, response of like wait for the next turn, just keep on solving. This is not going to help us out in getting the clarification regarding the questions, right? And yes, that is, as you said, our discussion forums remain more or less silent from the other side. Some effort should be taken so that it would remain also active from the teaching assistant side or the instructor side. But one thing I would like to highlight, a very beautiful feature of NPTEL here, the live sessions with the instructors. I think very rarely we used to get it in other forum. But the live sessions of our instructors, our professors from IITs, it's a very awesome one. I think they used to clarify a lot of many doubts. Even if there is some mistakes in the questions, they used to so humbly put it before the participants, like, these are the mistakes, these questions have to be removed, and this is the new things are going to be added. This question will be re-evaluated. I mean, this is a very beautiful sessions we used to have whenever the instructor comes to live sessions. That is first thing. Second thing, one distinct feature I would like to highlight here, I had also presented that things in my presentation also. In the other platform, predominantly I have gone for Coursera. I would like to tell you, in the discussion forum, they used to club together similar type of questions with a common link. That's a very beautiful feature I find, because whenever I used to get the discussion forum of the Coursera, suppose I have a particular questions regarding a particular assignment. Once I type that things, a particular link will appear. And that link, if I'll click it, all set of discussions, all set of questioning pertaining to that doubts, pertaining to that project assignments will be there only. I need not wonder about here and there to find out where I'll be getting the correct answer. And that feature is a very excellent one I find in the Coursera, which I think the NPTEL forum would like to introduce into that. That would be a good idea, sir. And regarding that particular one thing, like peer-reviewed assignments, I'm a little bit skeptic here because I would like to put my doubts here. I don't know who are the peers are going to review my assignments, first of all. Second, I don't know, suppose Coursera platform is concerned, I don't know who are the peers going to evaluate my assignments and what are their understanding levels. And if you are really going to implement it in NPTEL, we have to seriously look into that, like how to classify the learner's level so that the peer assignments can be given to them for the evaluations. So these are the points I would like to highlight here.
So I would like to just comment on your that forum question. So I think that the mentor concept, that is mentor concept provides a proper guidance to students which is not present in other course providers. Also, mentor concept encourages students and it gives the idea and the excitement of just to express something. And as far as concerned with peer grading, NPTEL is a good with that. It just gives assignments. And one thing I like about that, the NPTEL gives only one attempt to attempt the assignments and to submit it. I would like to tell something that I have also completed a course in Coursera. So what is there that I would what I not like about Coursera is that the when the assignments are there, I don't know how many can I say that the assignments, there are three attempts. First of all, there are three attempts to attempt the quizzes, and then it's when we didn't get pass in three attempts, it says that you should try again after some time, or that is some 8 to 10 hours later. So what I heard that the in Coursera, students just change their time. Students just skip that time or change that time to just keep that time to reattempt the quiz, and they get just pass. So this is the thing I didn't like about Coursera, or I don't know other course providers might do the same, but this is not in the NPTEL, so it's good for the NPTEL. And as far as grading, that's very good, but there are glitches in NPTEL, so that might be improved.
Okay, yeah, thanks. Thanks Ritik, thanks for your input.
According to me, the NPTEL has the NPTEL assignment have the time flexibility is very good by than other courses. Currently, I'm pursuing a course on the TCS icons. Mm-hmm. Lockdown to lockdown. There is quiz. I mean, there is some content. After they have finished the content, there is quiz, and there are 8 number of the attempts. It is very ridiculous. And but there is one point is that they does not show the answer of the quiz by resolving the quiz, and also they changes the their questions. This is my point of view.
Okay, Pranati. Yeah, thank you for your view. And I see that Suraj has something to say, share. Yeah, you can close your video. So Suraj, you wanted to add something to the general discussion that is happening?
Yes, sir. I would like to add something. Huh? As already mentioned by earlier speakers regarding other platforms, I will not name those platforms, but same thing happens. It would be like I will scratch your back, you will scratch mine. So during peer graded assignment, what happens on that platforms? They are just putting comment on your assignment that I have already reviewed your assignment, now it's your time, and I have given 5 out of 5 or some kind of grades, now it's your turn to review my assignment. This is how it's going on. And as Mohini sir and other speaker, even Avdesh Gupta ji has also mentioned, there is no, what we can say, there is no credibility as such. And even as Avdesh ji has mentioned, one of his colleague or friend has done 27 course. Same thing has been happening because the MOOC providers have made it free access all across India, and they have put some, like up to 30th of June, they can access the number of courses what they want. So they have been just consuming the content, and the 4-week course has been completed within 1 day or 2 days of time. So even we are not sure the certifications has been done during this period will be valid, will be accepted by industry in future or not. Again, same thing. Again, the whole purpose of the same privilege will not be successful. But in case of NPTEL, since they are not releasing quiz answers and other thing, so I find it very useful, though there would be honor code and other thing, but again, it is subject to the individual, how they do follow it and how do they do not.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, thank you. Yeah, I agree. Yes, peer reviews have its own fair share of critics. And yes, I agree, maybe lot of different things can happen in a peer graded assignment. Thank you, Suraj sir, for sharing your views. So what we are now moving to is that final aspect of the major points that you have highlighted. One is the discussion about the certification or the credibility and validity of the certificate. So I'll just pose that question. The value of certificate both among Indian institutions, we know that yes, there are mechanisms like credit transfer that bring in this one. And also among employers, what is the validity that you see about the NPTEL certificates? So I'll start with the hand raise. So Padmini ma'am has already said that NPTEL exams, because of that proctored exam, it is a genuine exam. And learners go about through unethical practices to generate certificate. Let me open up the floor. So I think I'll first go with, so I had said that I'll come back to some learners specifically. So first I'll take Shikha. I think Shikha had asked me to, Shikha, are you there? You wanted to,
yes,
say,
sir.
Yeah, you wanted to say something about the certification. Yeah, please go ahead.
Yes, sir. Okay. Yes, sir. Sir, I would like to put light on 3 main points which I have experienced while learning from NPTEL. First of all, NPTEL is some way more good than other websites in providing certificates in terms of credibility. Like they conduct genuine exams at the exam centers, whereas in other websites we get assignments based on our assignments we get scores and we complete that course. But in NPTEL, genuine examinations take place at the exam centers. And the next point is some things that NPTEL can improve. Like,
yeah.
While children are moving towards Coursera courses from NPTEL is that the courses which are offered on Coursera are from the universities, from the foreign universities which are ranked above the universities and colleges of India. So they prefer, like, if they will do a course from a higher ranked university, then they will it will get them more benefits and credibility, means they can learn far much better. So if NPTEL can collaborate and invite some faculties from other foreign universities, that would be a good point for NPTEL. And the next thing is that for soft skills, I would recommend NPTEL to motivate students and to put focus on mainly project based evaluations for the soft skills based project, because I have done some courses from edX also where for some courses they did evaluation based on our projects. They had some platforms for our project evaluations, and so when I see on LinkedIn several people putting on their certificates, but there the recruiters mainly put on the comments there that these certificates are just not enough for proving your skills. You need to show off your skills through some projects also. So for improving credibility, these projects are a good factor. Like ethical hacking, like courses like ethical hacking, web development, projects can be a good way to evaluate other than assignments and examinations at exam center, because then also we can just mug up all the things and just in the examination center we can get scoring marks and we can get just passing marks also, we can pass the course. So these are the okay. 3 points.
What I was trying to put in my point was like there could be some mechanism that the certificates could be integrated with the professional professional employers that that can be given weightage while we are sitting for interviews or even in academics. Like if for some reason some student is not able to attend the lectures, then if he or she had done a certification in that particular lecture, then some weightage could be given to the TA marks and allocation according to it.
Okay. Yeah, so this is what we call as credit transfer, and there are modalities that it has to be worked out by individual universities. So that is where it is stuck. But yeah, we are also working with universities in understanding how regular college going students can benefit from the NPTEL certificate. In their regular academic curriculum. So I see a lot more. Yeah, thanks, Akash. Let me read out certain comments that are coming in the chat forum. Because of paucity of time, I may not be able to open up the discussion forum for a lot more students, a lot more of these discussions. But yeah, please put in your points in the chat so that we can actually look at. So Vignesh is saying that we can attend assignments any number of times. Actually, this freedom is not good in teaching learning process in Coursera because you come to know the answer and you are, it is being supported by LDIN. So Dr. Ravish has responded, thanks to all members of NPTEL for fulfilling dreams of Indian learners. Hope a day will come when a student will receive undergraduate and postgraduate certifications or degree from reputed institutions and universities through NPTEL platform. Thank you, sir. So Padmini ma'am has a couple of points. Value of certificates can be given more importance by government, like giving exemption for written exam by going to next level. Like if it is your NET exam, SET exam, they get exemptions for interview. Candidate who have got elite or gold can be exempted from writing the exams. Gold and other things happen after the exam. So I'm not sure how much of this would be applicable. But yeah, we can think of something like this. But yeah, one thing that everybody has to understand is each NPTEL course is unique. Each offering, even though it may be the same course, a rerun is also a unique instance. So that is why this is not considered as a degree. Rather, it is a certification exam. So really sorry that I could not take up more of your inputs at this point, because we have started this at 5 and it is almost now we are reaching 7 o'clock, which is like the hard cutoff for the webinar. That is why I'm not able to reach out to each and everyone. Please put in your comments in the chat window so that I can look at it. And also, so Dhanya, you can take a note of the chat transcripts that are coming, and we can actually put that in the maybe while we are doing the webinar part of it in the video, main video.
Sure. Sir, actually I am studying in AKTU, and my college is giving credit transfer as per the course duration. Like for 4 week course, the credit points are less. For 8 weeks and 12 weeks course, the credit points are more. So these credit points are adding up, and these are valuable for getting an honors degree in BTech. So that's the solo motive of doing NPTEL courses initially. But then when I started learning from NPTEL courses, I really liked the course content, but I do not prefer going for the videos. Rather, I preferred reading from the slides and the content material, because you know I have to manage with the course curriculum also. So these things were there. So, and also the videos were too lengthy. So I found it a bit
boring and monotonous, so I preferred notes and prepared for the exam by from the PDF files as well. So the content in the PDF files was just enough to get, you know, get maximum marks. So I earned one gold certificate also without even watching a single video on the course. Means I just reviewed the study material and prepared from the study material only and given the exam and passed with good grade. So there's one thing also I wanted to add, means when I attended the course on Coursera, there was this concept that the screen was divided into two sections. See, one section was there where the video was playing, and the other section was given to us to, you know, side by side practice what is being taught there. So
which course was this in Coursera?
It was designing. It was something related to designing, the graphic designing.
Okay. If you can remember the course name, can you share it with us?
I think I have.
Sir, it's not course. Let me add. It's not course. It's guided project. He was talking about.
Okay.
They have started with new project called Guided Project Concept. They have acquired Rhyme Company.
Yes.
And take the projects available.
Okay. Yes. Go ahead, Dad. Go ahead, Sakshar.
So this thing I liked about them, and those one of my friend told me that they were using online interpreters side by side, so that they could practice the code on hand with the video also. So these things I liked about Coursera, and the other thing is that the availability of the course. So with Coursera, you can almost take up any course whenever you are free and whenever you want to start up. But with NPTEL, you have to wait for the certain time frame to end. But that's the part of curriculum, you see, that they are conducting exams. And so this cannot be changed. But yeah, that's the one point I would like. And the other thing I observed was the course, can I take names of the courses?
Yeah. Go ahead.
So there was one course on NPTEL, Enhancing Soft Skill and Personality. So all the answers to the assignment were available on YouTube. So many of my friends who were preparing with Meena, they just copied it. And I got to know about this very late. So I was preparing from the content provided and I was answering from there, but they just copied one day ago or 2 days ago, means 1 hour or 2 hours early, and they are just getting good marks. So this thing I like to highlight it here. So please look into that thing. The answers were being provided on YouTube.
Yeah, and so you said that you are planning for doing honors, I mean BTech honors.
Yes.
Do you have any of your, let's say, your friends or seniors who have completed BTEC honors using this, using NPTEL courses or others, from where you got inspired or you got some Q-tips?
No, I think this credit transfer was being implemented in AKTU from my semester only, means when I entered the first year. Earlier, it was like getting 75%, more than 75% in every semester was enough to get a honors degree. But from the year which I entered AKTU, then this was some kind of restriction that you have to get certain credit points for getting an honors degree.
Okay.
So
have you asked your, so do you have juniors?
No, actually I'm in second year. So okay. Yeah, my friends are there. They are taking up NPTEL courses.
Okay, so they allow you to start courses right from first year for BTEC honors, right? You're saying. Okay. These points also give a lot of boost to us here at NPTEL, seeing that there are scope for improvement. And we are also taking, there are certain courses where we have taken the right direction. So we will continue with these kind of experimentation so that it can come up widely in across all our courses. In the upcoming semester, we have 400 plus courses that are there. And one important thing that I have to highlight is this idea of local chapters that is very much unique to NPTEL. NPTEL has this idea of working along with Indian universities. So this is something that we highlight at every presentation. So we may not have, what do you say, superior production values like what edX or other or a Coursera gives. We may not do self-paced courses. We may not do that much of focus on superior production value simply because this MOOC platform is with a primary aim of addressing the quality of learning in general Indian education. So we are what we are doing right now is we are trying to NPTEL is the national coordinator of engineering courses primarily. But what we have doing in this space is we are also including courses from other areas like arts management. So this semester we have courses in law also coming to NPTEL portal. So we have two courses in law, which is coming from, I think, National Law University, Bangalore. We'll have a confirmation. If you look at our tentative course list, you will see that. There are a lot of things that we are also doing at the back end. We are trying to develop an analytics team. We are trying to come up with new initiatives like what you see right now, why NPTEL, what NPTEL. So we have done a Spockathon and those kind of things. We are also trying to bring in ideas of learner centricity in NPTEL courses. There are courses called designing learner-centric MOOCs or designing learner-centric content in STEM disciplines, e-learning content in STEM disciplines that we are offering through NPTEL. So one thing that you have to understand is an NPTEL is actually a platform primarily to empower learners. So none of our initiatives are with a mindset of a for-profit, okay? We are a completely not-for-profit organization. It is a project by Government of India. So we are also not, what do you say, permanent employees as say. So we work in this field so that we have a passion towards all the people working in NPTEL has a passion towards how people are learning, how can we improve the quality of Indian education. So that is the single most driving force if you look at what NPTEL is doing. Of course, we have tied up with AICTE in offering FDP certificates for our courses. And also, we are trying to reach out to industry partners for fee waivers and other kind of support through their CSR initiatives. So what you see right now are some of the, if you look at the NPTEL project, it is a vast ocean. And what you see as certification courses is just one small part of it. We do a lot of different things. We try to bring up a lot of new content and all your ideas. It is going back to our team. It is going back to the group. And we will be thinking, deliberating over the ideas that you have been saying. And we'll try to come up with very, very focused initiatives. It may take a certain time because we also have to identify which all courses, so it has to be piloted. Though these kind of experiments are happening across small courses. So we will do most of this, most of the suggestions that you have given. So I hope this was a productive session for all.